I'm prepared to sacrifice anything.
This tourney, how's it work exactly?
It is the year's grandest and most important contest. Knights from all corners come to face off for the grand prize, and more importantly, for glory. A demanding test of knightly prowess in horsemanship, marksmanship, and fencing. I qualified for the first time, had great hopes of winning. Yet...
Yeah, I get it. Anything for Vivian. Fine, I'll look into it. Gotta admit, piqued my curiosity.
I shall be forever in your debt. Now, we must ensure you are not eliminated from the tourney before you can meet Vivian.
Meaning?
Could you show me how you shoot, ride and fight, perchance? And you must learn the tourney rules, know how to apply them in practice. I did not mean to suggest I doubt your abilities. Everyone must train, even a witcher. Besides, the tourney contests must surely differ, require skills you don't usually apply, races above all. The choice is yours. Where shall we start?
Greetings. Want to join the lists?
Naturally. We must first see to formalities, however. At Guillaume's request, I have looked into your personal history in its heraldic aspects.
Really? What did you come up with?
My findings show you may take part as Geralt of Rivia.
What a surprise.
Or as the Honorable Ravix of Forhorn. It's not every year we have a combatant who can boast of two crests. Which do you prefer?
Kinda curious what you could have learned about Geralt of Rivia.
In the year 1267, a certain Geralt, a member of the Witcher's Guild, was knighted by Queen Meave and dubbed Geralt of Rivia. This was in honor of his distinguished service at the Battle of the Bridge, said structure spanning the Yaruga. But I wager you know of which battle I speak.
Yeah, those were the days. Kahir and I led a fistful of Nordlings against an entire Nilfgaardian battalion. Won that battle just because we absolutely had to cross the river. Ravix of Forhorn? How'd you manage to dig that up?
Here in Toussaint, we treat heraldry very seriously. One visit to the ducal archives. That is all I needed to acquire the necessary information. Ravix of Forhorn was the name under which you attended a feast honoring Princess Pavetta, daughter of Queen Calanthe of Sintra, on the occasion of her 15th birthday.
That's actually right. I'm Geralt, not about to fight under a false name.
You may now take the shields bearing your crest.
I'm a witcher. Shields aren't something witchers ever use in combat.
Who mentioned using it in combat? Not I. The shield commemorates your participation in the tourney. You may take it as a souvenir.
In that case, thanks.
Have you been instructed as to the tourney's challenges, prizes, and vows? If not, I do hope you will allow me to tell you about them.
Use my credits. I give no shits. No shits are given. Zero shits given.
Guillaume told me a bit about the contests. Rather make sure I'm clear on them, though.
An admirable thirst for knowledge. There are contests three. A shooting range, where you will compete side by side with an opponent. A horse race, during which you will seek to complete the course within a specified time. Any targets hit with bolts or dummies felt with blade will increase the time you have. Finally, the group melee in the arena, crowned with a duel against last year's champion. As each contest ends, its results will be posted on the board outside my tent. This way, all will be apprised of who leads at any given moment.
Convenient.
This is getting super entertaining. Yeah, look at me
ride out with it. I'm a sucker for prizes.
The winner of each contest shall receive a trophy. Whoever has the best result once all contests have played out shall face last year's champion in a final duel for glory and the title. Should you defeat the reigning champion, the grand prize will be yours. This year, a sword forged especially for this occasion by the one and only Cornelius of Asengard, a famed master weaponsmith. Her illustrious highness had it brought all the way from Nassau.
You say something about vows?
As is our custom, knights make vows to which they hold for the duration of the tourney. Each swears on something which to him represents his most cherished virtue.
Feels like I know everything I'd ever want to know about chivalric tourneys.
Splendid. In that case, you must make your vow. Upon what would you like to swear it?
I vow on the love of my lady, Yennefer of Vengerberg, to respect the chivalric virtues.
May the gods succor you in your endeavors to overcome. The sign here, please, then fill out these forms. That is all I need from you. Now, as arranged by Guillaume, you shall be fitted with appropriate armor for the tourney.
Shiny.
You have also been assigned a tent for the tourney's duration. It stands near the arena. Good luck.
Salute you! The honor and duty of tourney patron have fallen to me this year. Fight honorably, so that I may bestow upon one of your number the tourney's grand prize! You have sworn your vows, you have readied body and soul. The time has come to test them!
Behold Horm Akispark of the Mechtian royal line. His name's quite the mouthful, a true challenge to rhyme. His targets to be hit centrally and true are the ones in blue. Against him new blood, a knight unknown till now. Sir Geralt of Rivia, give us a bow. The targets he must with his quarrels thread are red.
May the better man win.
Like a lover ghostly grasping but one fair teat, Geralt's half swoon twixt joyous victory and bitter defeat. Geralt.
Damn! Gotta be quick.
Sir Geralt of Rivia has trounced his foe. Pounded him soundly, immersed him in woe.
Your prize, sir. A crossbow adorned with your crest. I congratulate you.
Thank you, my lady. Would you tell me about the other prizes?
Alas, I cannot devote more time to you than to the other combatants. I have duties to attend to. Forgive me.
My medallion's vibrating strongly. Can only mean one thing. Magic.
The explanation is disappointing, I'm afraid. The fragrance I use, it's mixed by a sorceress.
To lose to an opponent such as you is a victory of its own. Accept my congratulations as well.
Thanks.
Good work!
In the interim, I managed to determine which tent Lady Vivian occupies. Perhaps you could find a clue within it.
You're right. Vivian's cursed in some way. Sensed it when she opened the tourney.
In that case, we've no time to lose. Let us go.
Yeah, let's go now.
This is her tent. You must look inside. Search it. I shall hoot like an owl should someone approach.
Claw marks, that's clear. Not sure what beast left them, just that it's big.
Oh,
jar of concealing ointment.
Thou hast doffed
how will magic at work
thy
here?
Locks. Thy lips are like a thread of scarlet. Thy two breasts are like...
Clothing's all dark green and yellow. Seems Yen's not the only one with a fixed color scheme. Hairs and salts. Used to make compresses. Oriole feather. Vivian keep a bird as a pet? No sign of it here, if so.
Someone approaches! Quickly!
You were supposed to hoot.
We shall speak later. We must return to the tourney now. It's time for the second contest.
Sirs, what seeks you in my lady's tent? Inspiration? Be gone from here!
Behold, gallant knights and ladies decorous! Gaze at the host assembled before us! Look upon chivalry's best and most storied! Come from far lands, here to seek glory! Hear now their names as I shout them aloud! Savor their titles, of their presence be proud! Palmerin the Baron of Longfall! Lyros of Metina! Rainfarn of Atta! Horm Makaspark of Meicht! Donimir of Troy! Guy de Boisfren, in service to the Duchess! Delwyn of Craigiau! Count Ty of Dondal! Ansay of Lyria and Rivia a Prince! Geralt of Rivia! For Gregoire of Mount Gorgon, let out a roaring cheer! The faint power of silence, tawny champion from last year! Today's winner of contests, his victory to secure, shall face Sir Gregoire in a challenge severe!
Does ignorance demand a bardic deceit? Does someone need telling how tourneys proceed?
How dare you enter a tourney for nobly born knights? Your knighthood came through the grace of my mother, Meath, Queen of Lyria and Riphia, whom you treacherously deserted mere days later. Your presence here is an offense to my honor.
And yours is an offense to my eyes. If you're done, step aside, Prince.
Burn!
The tourney's protector, the mate Vivian. Her beauty entrances both beasts and men.
My heart's greetings, dear knights. May my grace guide you and show you the path of honor, valor, and... Accept my wishes of good fortune, sir. and devote all your strength to the tourney, and only it.
The time has come for you, Sir Knight. Mount your steed. Swift be your flight.
Ladies and gentlemen of lineage illustrious, soon steeds shall swarm like ants most industrious. To beat time's passage, they'll ride like the gale. What a sight to behold, what a lark, what a tale! Before us, Geralt, from Rhythia come, fast as the wind, bright as the sun.
Up now.
So close, will he last? Endure and keep pace.
Take it easy.
Can you get there?
Of such style, such grace, such speed. To watch was a pleasure, a treat indeed. To honor our entrance, praise each fair knight. We shall feast from eve till dawn's first light. The finest of wine and food shall be served. If you've blood in your veins, come collect what's deserved.
I congratulate you. Here, your prize. A saddle adorned with your crest.
Many thanks.
By the way, my mate saw a man with white hair sneak out of my tent. Did you know who it might have been?
No idea.
How juvenile.
Congratulations on your win. In stellar style, no less. Ah, I no longer regret I was not able to participate. Almost.
We must drink to this. Come with me to the feast. We shall await Vivian together.
Lead the way.
Sometime later. How specific.
So, any thoughts on Vivian?
Her beauty's striking.
That is not what I ask.
Still too early to say anything I'd be willing to stand behind. Managed to figure one thing out. She uses powerful magic, masking illusions.
Do you mean to say she might in truth look different than she seems?
Only guessing right now. Found some clues. Got me wondering if your beloved Vivian's not a Bruxa.
A Bruxa? You mean a vampiress?
Not sure yet.
We've still some time before Vivian arrives. Let us drink.
Okay.
To Vivian, may you find the means to aid her.
To Vivian.
When I first laid eyes on her, I finally understood what all those poems and ballads were trying to say.
Love's not poetry alone. Sometimes it's prose. Sometimes it's just plain ugly.
You say that only because you do not know Vivian as I do. A life with her would be sweetness itself.
Actually, you don't know her all that well either.
Your presence at this tourney is an affront to my honor. I demand satisfaction.
Head to the nearest brothel, then.
Coward. Mounted combat in the main arena. I challenge you.
All right, fine,
fine. Since you insist, I'm all yours.
You shall bitterly regret deserting my mother's army once I've done with you.
Aw, this guy. Let's teach him a lesson.
May the blood I will spill wash away the stain of your cowardice.
Let's get
damn.
This over
doing
with.
That kind of thing now?
Quick.
3, 2, 1.
Yeah, whatever. Let's see if we can't one-shot this guy. We're gonna put on all, and I mean all of the buffs. Critical. Just because I don't feel like messing with it once we get there. Too bad. Sit down, little man. Couldn't quite get the one shot, but hey.
Unknown, except
we'll take it.
The gods have chosen to punish me with defeat. But do not think your cowardice will be forgotten.
I know, look at you, bitch.
You still going on about that? Need to clear this up once and for all. Had to abandon your mother's camp back then because someone else needed my help. Badly. Couldn't refuse them. Didn't want to, in fact.
You mean to say
You had a secret mission, set off to accomplish it, having vowed to tell no one of its nature, until you did?
Something like that, minus the vow. And, I'd still rather not divulge the nature of my secret mission. Can you accept that as justification?
In agreeing to duel, you proved yourself a true knight. Thus, I accept your word as that of a man of honor.
Glad to hear it. Now I got work to do.
All right, man.
Wrecked his ass.
Oh, damn, I'm ugly.
My heart swells to behold this beautiful celebration of valor and honor, and to witness you, who embody the chivalric virtues in your lives, strive for greatness. Yet, after a time of combat must come a time of peace and respite. Thus, I invite all who fought in the tourney to this feast held in your, and none other's, honor. And should any among you crave solitude, private tents await you nearby. The group melee shall take place on the morrow. Glory shall be within grasp for each and every one of you.
This
the best
among you
shall have the honor to face our reigning champion, the famed Grégoire de Gourgon, victor of last year's tourney.
Oh.
Celebrate, make merry, revel as you will.
He's really tall.
Yet be mindful of the trial that awaits you tomorrow.
Let's get wasted. I say we get wasted. I think he agrees. Let's go get wasted. Goodbye, 9 foot tall man. Yeah, get some white honey in me.
Follow her. We shall meet in your tent before your last contest. You must help her.
Oh no, we don't want to do that. No, we don't want to do that. Yes, much better. Now we actually look presentable.
That Greydome scoundrel, ever seeking Lady Vivien. Some kind of
drunk is indeed drunk. Was that her out there? It's gotta be with that gold shimmering hair. Wait a second.
Strange. Was sure I'd find her here. Vanished. Melted into thin air. And that bird. She and Ruxa flew off. Worth going after.
Yeah.
Bird flew off over the hill. Might be quicker to pass through the cave.
Shit. Well, that sounds good.
Sign of the bird anymore. Guillaume mentioned a clearing in the woods. Vivien strolling around it at night. Could find her there.
Witcher.
Lady Vivian? Counted on me getting lost.
I did. I thought you no different from the knights. Good at tourneys, hopeless in the face of true danger. I was mistaken.
So you're not actually a Bruxa?
A what?
Suspicion I had that you might be a vampire. Certain details seemed to confirm it. Then I changed my mind. Anyway, unimportant. Here you come to this clearing often.
This is where it all began. And as I was not able to evade you, save myself from you, that I wanted them here. In this very spot. With no witnesses.
Want what done?
Why, you are a witcher. You were hired to kill me, were you not? Then do so, now. And do it quickly, I beg you. I shan't resist.
Witchers only aren't monsters. And even then, not all. You're no monster.
Then what am I to your eyes?
Furry.
Most likely you've been cursed. Don't know
yep, she's a furry.
Why yet, but I hope to find that out soon.
If you've no contract on my life, just at all, did Guillaume put you up to it? Is that why?
He wanted to help you. Asked me to do him a favor. Frankly, if I can do something for you, I'll do it, willingly.
Why should I trust you?
Because the Duchess trusts me. Because I'm a freak, too. Because cases like yours are my bread and butter. Take your pick.
You shall not turn on me. Use what I say against me. You shall not tell anyone?
Of course not.
You got nothing to fear. Came here to help you. And I won't peep a word to anyone unless I decide it's absolutely necessary.
So be it. I shall tell you what my mama once told me. When she was with child, expecting me, she and my father spent much time together near the wood, here in this clearing. Mama loved to listen to the oriole sing. She would stroke her belly and say, "My daughter should be as beautiful as that bird. Such is my wish." But a creature dwelt in the wood who envied my parents their happiness. One day it appeared before them to say the whole wood belonged to it. And they had dared to delight in something that was not theirs. It demanded payment. And when my parents said that they had nothing, it claimed their unborn daughter as its own.
Parents ever described the creature?
They called it a nymph born of the deep woods, with no mother or father. But I was too young, too distraught by the curse's onset to ask after details.
What happened after that?
Nothing at first. I came into the world a perfectly normal child, and my parents forgot that day's events. But 15 summers into my life, the curse began to show. Initially only when the moon was full, but now it's advanced so that even in daytime I must use magic ointment to mask its symptoms, to look normal. Thus, I thought someone had discovered my secret, then hired you to kill me. In fact, I was resigned to death in coming here. Perhaps death would be preferable to my complete and permanent transformation. For I fear that is what lies in store.
Ointment you use includes a potent magic ingredient. You don't have the immunity mages have. Use heavy doses, or normal doses too long, and it could be dangerous to you.
I sensed this. The very reason I knew I would have to give it up in the end and bid my human form a final farewell.
The curse. It could be reversible. Once ran into a baron transformed into a cormorant, ostensibly for good. Managed to cure him completely.
And you truly think you could do something like this for me?
Can't guarantee a thing. Tough case yours. You were cursed before birth. That alone complicates things. Also, you claim the curse is increasing its hold. Symptoms are progressing. Could try transferring the curse onto someone else.
What? Out of the question. I shall not allow it to ruin an innocent life. Is this the only method you know?
Only one that's completely safe.
So there is another.
All right, there is another. Ancient ritual. We'd need an Oriole egg. Should release the curse's grip permanently. Gotta warn you, though. Could have serious consequences.
Consequences? What kind?
Curse was cast before you came into this world. Ritual involved transferring it to an as-yet-unhatched chick. You'd be free. Thing is, you could be left with the average lifespan of an Oriole.
7 years. I understand. Alas, every rose has its thorn, and there are no happy endings. Yet truth be told, I never thought I would get one. I came here prepared to die, yet you wish to give me 7 years of life. Real life, free life. This is no dilemma. I agree, wholeheartedly.
I see why. I understand. Don't have to decide just yet. Think it through.
I will. They must miss me at the Tawny Grounds by now. Shall we? Return.
Let's. But are you gonna...
Yes. I cannot appear there all in feathers. Pardon me for a moment.
Freaking furries, man. There's your M rating.
You can change at will?
No. But I discovered the water of this pool helps, brief, but I can always be sure of them.
Interesting.
Come.
Did you learn anything?
Yeah.
Then speak, man. Can you not see I'm out of my mind with worry? What ails her?
She asked me not to talk about it.
But I want only the best for her. Perhaps I shall be able to help or, I don't know, console her at the least.
We were both right, actually. It is a curse. One that's transforming Vivian into a bird. Her condition's getting worse.
Gods! A curse that is a worse affliction than disease. What now? Can you help her?
That'll depend on her. I'll try if she asks me. Significant risks involved, though. Shortening her life to about another 7 years included.
What? This is not what we agreed.
Tough case. Curse's hold on her grows stronger every day. And I'm a witcher, not a miracle worker. Heard of one other method that could work. Curse could be lifted via her reflection, say in a pool of water. Thing is, we'd need someone who'd willingly assume the burden of the curse. Take it on in her stead.
You mean, become a bird themselves?
Theoretically. See, curse grows weaker once it's transferred. Might end up as just an appetite for seeds and worms. All outcomes are on the table, though. Death included.
I am prepared to sacrifice. Give my life for her. Just as King Friedank's knight did for the beautiful Queen Sero.
Knew that already. But are you prepared to swallow bugs for the rest of your life?
Yes.
Which method do you believe to be best for Vivian?
Don't know yet.
But you have some notion, have you not? Do not tell me you seriously consider drastically shortening her life when I stand prepared to shoulder the burden.
Method using a pool of water is better. Poses no threat to Vivian.
Naturally. You must know you can count on me. I shall bear it all. But Vivian, I fear she might be too proud to agree to such a thing.
I'll meet her after the last contest. Talk to her. She could agree.
I'm counting on you, Witcher, and I'm content we finally know something. What now? We know all, so you need not see the tourney through. You could withdraw. True, I shall get an earful from the Herald should you fail to show for the last contest, but it's nothing I can't handle. So, what will it be?
I don't back out of anything. I'll take part in the last skirmish. Besides, Vivian will be busy till the tourney's end.
Indeed. In that case, you must meet the other knights of your team. They await near the arena's entrance, by the training ground.
Got it. Thanks.
I know now the two teams' rosters. I shall be captain of ours. That means you shall do as I say for the duration of the fight. Is this clear? Palmer and Alonso will lead the opposing team. With this skirmish, we commemorate the Battle of Fox Hollow of 1218, when a handful of southern outlaws led by Hallar the Brown attacked Tucson only to be driven off by brave knights, thus setting a precedent. Since that day, knights errant have guarded the duchy's borders. Palmerin drew the short straw, so his team shall play the barbarian Hallar's men. Any questions?
None.
I doubt you will do us any good. You know nothing of knightly combat as a witcher. Try at least to stay out of our way.
It is time, gentlemen. Take your weapons and proceed to the arena.
Cheer for the lords. For our next entertainment, the team shall cross swords. Two rifle crews, two coteries shall fight full tilt till one drops to its knees.
Where did that sword come from?
Or lance blows unclean shall forever be branded as shameful, obscene. While the knights prepare, let me say I'm elated to behold such a crowd on edge, breath baited. Whoever here wins, the past champion shall face. All others must leave, heads bowed in disgrace.
Let's do it. See real quick, like we're gonna do one of these real quick. Oh.
Let us begin! Crowd, raise a ruckus! Blood, sweat, and tears shall soon follow in buckets.
Pure swordsmanship, eh?
Never learn.
The last two evil. Beat it out of you.
Sorry, Palmerin. Nah, who am I kidding? I don't care at all. Skadoosh!
Alone Geralt stands, alone he fights on, but inside does he weep for those who have gone.
Badoom. Badoom. Goodbye.
The world's never seen a fight quite so glorious. For showing such verve, each knight was victorious. Yet in tourneys as in life, but one champion may reign. Today, he is the one. Praised be his name. He felt a whole host slew the most. To Geralt of Rivia, who the strength of lions boasts. He sailed through all trials, each test he passed with ease. But now awaits the last. Bring him to his knees. For Grimwald de Gorgon, who on this ground's last won, shall spar him for the title, and the day is done. To the tired remainder, we salute your endeavors. Return to
into
your
lives, your lovers, your whomevers. I still love that line. It's great. What's up, cheeky baby? More loading screens. Yay! I love loading screens. They're great.
It is time. Step into the arena. Should you suffer grievous harm during combat, have you any last wishes? Any missives you wish passed to your loved ones?
Thanks, I'm fine. Nah.
The Witcher of Rithia, Geralt his name. Though aged be his visage, do not disdain. His locks true are white, but he was born to fight. Now entering the grounds, a titan of infamy, Gregoire de Gorgon, victor of Lassus Tony.
Oh boy. Looks like quite the man right there.
I wish both combatants good fortune and fame.
Aw, thanks, Lady Vivian. Let's see, I still got some thunderbolts, some hangman's venom. Oh, do I have signs now? Nope, okay. Alright. Best attack. Yo, what? Not cool, not cool. Yo, what? No, this ain't cool. Yo, that's definitely not what we want. Do we win? Aw, yeah!
Geralt of Rivia!
That's what's up.
This is champion to behold! He defeated Gregoire de Gorgon! Hail Geralt! Geralt!
That's what's up. Ooh, do we win something? Ooh, shiny!
I've the honor to decorate our grand champion.
Me want. Give it to me. I want it now.
His love for his heart's captor, and it was doubtless this vow that carried him to this splendid victory. He showed great courage, great strength, great composure.
A sword made out of gold.
Nobly with honor, and thus rightfully deserves the title of this year's champion of the arena.
I need to talk to you.
Not now. We shall meet later in my tent. I have duties to attend to, as do you.
Geralt's of Rivia's sword. Yay, money.
Said, I wish to endanger no one and thus choose the method involving an egg. If it's to be the egg of an Oriole, I know where to find one. There is a nest in my clearing. Might you explain the nature of the ritual? Its exact course?
Sure. Want to tell you something, though. think we should try the alternate method first.
I was clear. It is out of the question.
Let me finish. Second method's less than reliable. To put it simply, might work, might not.
But it will. I shall save you, oh lovely Vivian.
Why are you here, sir? This is a private conversation.
Oh, boy.
He's not your foe. Got good intentions. You guessed right. He hired me, but only because he wanted to help you.
Be not angry, my lady. You no longer bear this burden alone. I know all.
You told him!
I know a curse afflicts you. A curse which grows more severe by the day. I understand how you feel. My aunt, Countess de Lawnful, once contracted a strange illness which ate away at her from the inside. She grew weaker by the day, the light fading from her eyes. I remember her saying the worst was not the pain, but losing mastery of her own body. She was so helpless. I fear you feel the same. The Witcher knows a way to lift the curse from you and let it rest on me. I wish to do this, to take it from you, Vivian.
Why?
Because I love you.
Aww, that's so cheesy.
I might have died in the arena. I sought to slay a Shalmar for you. But now I see the fool I was. Now I see how I risked my life for no purpose. Yet, with this, I can truly do something for you.
I do not wish to inflict this horror on anyone. You saw how it looks, Witcher. I turn to you as one elder and hopefully one wiser as well.
Nah, I ain't wise.
Do you think this a good idea?
Hell no, this is a horrible idea. We should never do it.
Worth a try, as I see it. Original curse fell on an unborn child. Doubt it'll take hold as strongly when transferred to a full-grown man.
You've now heard the expert opinion. Let us do this together, Vivian.
Very well. I was prepared to die. Thus, I am also prepared to attempt something mad. Now, we must go to my pool in the woods, yes?
Yep.
Everything's agreed, so no point wasting any more time. Let's go.
Oh. You can't touch this. Oh, we're assuming the position. And here comes the furries. God, I freaking hate furries, man. Yeah, just kidding. It's each their own. Oh, look, a golden Oriole.
So, this is my true form. It is not too late. You may still change your mind. It will bring no shame.
My mind is made up. My resolve is firm. If you can handle it, so will I. You are beautiful to me, even as you stand now.
Oh, that's clearly rubbish.
Well, he seems committed. Aww, hand and talon.
How nice. Shut your eyes, both of you, and don't move.
Guillaume?
Yes, my love?
If you become as I am now, I wish you to know I shall not leave you.
Aww.
Picture yourselves reflected in a pool of water. Focus on that. Now, open your eyes. Damn, I think it might have worked.
Oh, Gary. Good old Gary. Oh no, she naked. Avert your eyes, children. How you doing there, champ?
Honestly, didn't think this would work. Doubted anything would happen. Read about this ritual in Grimoires. Descriptions all seemed dramatic, embellished, all stipulated a condition that seemed improbable.
What condition was this?
A real bond between those involved. True love. How do you feel, in general? You feel it change, Guillaume?
I was struck hard, as if by a battering ram, but now I feel not at all different. Apart from a slight itch on my skin. Are you certain it worked?
Yes, something happened, definitely. Must be an intersection beneath this pond. Powerful magic at work here. Look at Vivian.
Yeah, she's all beautiful again.
What now?
The happy couple.
Now? Now you get to live together, happily ever after. Still, watch yourselves carefully. Notice any troubling symptoms, find me.
Naturally. I thank you, Garrett. Oh, and your payment.
At last! I've so much to make up
for. Ooh, lots of money.
Balls to attend, distant lands to see.
Free at last, as a bird.
Ha! I found you droll. I had not noticed before.
But you will not fly away without me.
That remains to be seen, I think. But I too must thank you, Witcher.
Don't mention it. You take care, both.